This is surprising that I wasn't planned to make a speech in the panelist side. I was just planning to make welcoming, but you give the word to me. I can say a few words on the exactly what Turkey, what Black Sea, what Mediterranean so far. I think the market of Black Sea itself has some challenges internally due to the reasons of the countries which is making the Black Sea as a region, the relations between these countries, the trades that these countries are having, the products that they are producing, and the logistic conditions in especially in the northern of Black Sea is just changing the whole let's say the whole concept in a difficult position. The reason is that to have a better and healthier sustainable business, the cross trades is helping the shipping line, is helping the logistics to just give the cost efficient solutions and to open new markets hinterlands. As Yieldport, beside our investment in Malta, we mainly invested in the gateway terminal. So we called ourselves as ports and logistics as Yieldport. So logistics is in generic, we say port centric logistics, which the activities, any kind of logistic activities that we are after to attract the cargo to the port. So this needs the hinterland extension. So when I see Black Sea, Turkey is one of the key point that they can go beyond their own hinterland from Black Sea to Mediterranean, to United States, to Black Sea, and to sorry, not Black, to the Northern Africa, then to Middle East and Far East with the container shipping and bulk shipping. We do operate bulk operations and container operations together, and in a very long time, Turkey is a point that where the Black Sea bulk cargo is containerized in Turkish ports with the bulk operation directly to container and then shipped to the end destination. So this type of logistic flexibility is in the ports. This type of logistic activities is helping the market in Black Sea. Although in the export part of Black Sea has some challenges due to the products they have. Today we see more agricultural products, less industrial products on container wise. This is having another challenge on the container shipping side. This is what we see. Some seasonal reefer movements we see from the southern part of Turkey to Black Sea is the seasonal volume that is not bringing the sustainable services to Black Sea. And we see lots of shipping lines, the regional ones and the global ones are making some alliances, some vessel sharing, and they are using the Marmara seaports as the transshipment. Of course, when we see Turkey as in heavily investing in the logistics and the infrastructure, we need more and better investments on the infrastructure of the rail as well, together with the road. Our road connections, our road trucking activities in Turkey is I think the largest fleet we have in Europe, and the main carrier to the main trade partner of Turkey, Europe, is the road transportation for sure. And as when I listen Ms. Ceyda, that GSV, I think in the short sea in Mediterranean, we see that the main competition is not in between the shipping lines, is in between the ro-ro lines, the trucking companies, and the container shipping. Same for Black Sea market. We see some ro-ro services, weak ro-ro services between Russia and Turkey and Ukraine and Turkey. Due to the limited activities, due to the limited cargo, there is not possible to increase this cargo, these flows, and to put much more cost-effective ones. But as we positioned ourselves in Turkey as the junction of the Black Sea, Europe, East and West trade, I think we can have better roles. I see a question asking of the Canal Istanbul project, which was popped up in several years ago from the president of Turkey, and we see some activities started. For sure, enlarging the capacity of the canal, because Bosphorus has a restriction of 299 meters of vessels, which is today we are talking about approximately 9,600 TEU vessels. Of course, with the canal, with the extended capacity, the bigger vessels can move into Black Sea. But the bigger vessels move into Black Sea means more cost for a coal. And that means the shipping lines need to make a profitable coal with an extra cost, and they need more cargo in and out. So this is, I think, the challenge after we opened Canal Istanbul. In several years later, I see it 4 or 5 years later, it can be opened. After that, I think the Black Sea market should just think on a way that how they can attract the imports in these trade lanes, and how they can bring these big vessels and make it profitable. Today, the only CMA CGM Ocean Alliance service, traditionally it was CMA CGM with the BEX vessels, are passing directly to Ukraine. We see as a strategic part of the trade, and the rest is transshipping from Marmara Sea, the main cargo from Black Sea to the main cargo from Far East to Black Sea. So this is, I think, showing that Black Sea as a region has something to do on the production of their goods and their country economical strategies. They should understand the advantages if they move to a more balanced traffic in their countries, and they can open new hinterlands. And also Turkey should understand that being in the just in the middle of this traffic can have better position. Today, Ambarlı port is leading, Ambarlı port, including Marport, is leading on these transshipments and such. But to have more feedering services, to have more connections, to improve the let's say multimodal transportation from Black Sea to Turkey will allow the shipping in Turkey to have more cargo through Black Sea, that's for sure. I think on the trade side, this is what I see. As yield port, we are investing in this, let's say, we are following the strategy and we are investing in the big capacity terminals in Turkey. Gebze and Gemlik both can handle the biggest vessels, has enough berth capacity for that. But on the other side, with the logistics we have, that we are trying to extend our hinterland, including feedering services. We are working on this strategy to attract more cargo from Black Sea to and from Black Sea in our Marmara Sea port. Two questions that I was raised in my opening speech is that what is the impact of COVID on shipping? I think the first impact was nobody realized that what is happening and the ports closed and the operational structure that the shipping lines has was affected, and they tried to save the day. But after a couple of months, in the second half of the year, the service structures are well organized, and I see a very fast and strong reaction from the shipping line that they rearrange their services, and then the shipping keeps moving. On the other side, due to the reasons of the freight rates increased globally, we see some shift from container cargo to bulk cargo. In our bulk terminals, we see that some of the cargo, general and bulk cargo, let's say break bulk, is now looking for bulk vessels to be shipped. These were actually not good paying cargo, as in the pipeline, some minerals, some sort of cement clinker operations we see. Is heavily moving to the bulk operations. And the second one was will COVID speed up the digitalization? I think the digitalization started for a long time ago and speed up with the most famous Bitcoin technology that pops up, and all the shipping lines are trying to make one single digital pipeline for the document sharing. I think this is increased. The the activities. And as Yieldport, we invested heavily on the technology, I can say, that we are sharing these informations on the these data chains, and we already are leading in the port activities that we are sharing with the customers and EDIs and this type of activities. And of course, we are all on the teams and we are meeting on the screens. I see just one point that I see these valuable speakers and us and some of the attendees I already know that has been in the industry for a long time and we know each other. When you know each other, when you know the industry and when you know the business, these teams and video conferences are working quite fine because what you're saying and what you understand is pretty much is simple. But for the new generation that we need to train and for the future of the market, I think it's very important to be on the field, on the facility to understand what port, what logistics, what shipping line, what vessel, what crane means. This is one of the points that COVID puts a brake. That's what I see. And it is very hard to explain or to give the right definition to the newcomers. And this is one of the points I would like to raise. So thank you again